I would like to thank everyone for joining us today. This is a presentation on ionized water and why it's better to drink than other types of water. So who am I? My name is Aldrin Ordell and I'm the owner of Water for Life USA. I have been doing this for almost 16 years now. My background is that I have a master's in psychology and I used to work as an elementary school counselor, a group home counselor, and I even helped adults with mental challenges to learn to do jobs so they could become self-sufficient. I bought my first water ionizer about 17 years ago. I read an article in a health food magazine that explained how the water that we were drinking from our taps and from bottled water was all stagnant water or dead water, and that the antioxidants and things that we needed in water was getting lost by that water sitting around for long periods of time. So in thinking about my experiences in college and working with children and adults with behavioral challenges, that I started to think, well, maybe talking to them wasn't the best way to help them. Maybe a better way to help people would be to teach them about their diets and how the acidity in their diets, the water that they drink, affects their overall health and even their mental functioning. So I got really inspired that this was the course that I wanted to take. I gave up on being a psychologist and focused on starting and running Water for Life USA. And since then, I have written hundreds to thousands of articles. They appear all over our website under the blog tab, but you also will see these articles copied in various places all over the internet. Even my competitors have copied a lot of the articles that I've written, which I guess is fine. I mean, I'm really happy that the information is getting out there. And as they say, you know, being copied is the ultimate form of flattery. So there you go. So let's talk about our bodies. Our bodies are made up of water. At least a high percentage of our body is water. It's about 60%. And our brain and heart are 73% water. Our lungs are 83% water. Our skin is 64% water. Our muscles and kidneys are 79% water. And even our bones are 31% water. So what this means is that the quality of the water that you drink every day is super important to the health of your body. This leads me to the number one problem that adults and children and older adults face, and that is dehydration. As much as 75% of adults are dehydrated. It's even more if you're older. Dehydration causes unclear thinking, mood changes, overheating, constipation, fatigue, and even kidney stones. So getting enough water is absolutely essential to our bodies functioning in a healthy way. Why is water important? Well, when we get enough water, it increases our energy and it relieves fatigue. So if you're struggling through your day, if it's 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon and you're feeling just absolutely zapped, it could be that you haven't had enough water to drink for the day. Water also keeps our body at a normal body temperature, which makes it function a lot better because it's not struggling to regulate body temperature and it can instead focus on other parts of our body that need attention. Water also lubricates and cushions our joints. It improves our skin complexion, it promotes weight loss, and it even flushes out the toxins from the food that we're in, beverages that we're consuming. So how much water should you be drinking to not be dehydrated? Well, men should be drinking about 15 and a half cups of water a day. That's about a gallon. And women should be drinking about 11 and a half cups of water per day, and that's about 3/4 a gallon. And since water is essential to the functioning of our body, the quality of the water is really, really important. So we're going to talk now about tap water. and the problems with drinking tap water. So drought is unfortunately a problem that we are facing all over the country, especially the West Coast. And because of drought conditions, our water quality is deteriorating. It's concentrating contaminants in our water supply, like heavy metals. And these heavy metals are carcinogenic, meaning they are cancer causing. And it's just not something that we want. And our municipal water treatment facilities are struggling to deal with this high concentration of contaminants caused by drought conditions. Another problem in our tap water is what they call PFAS. PFAS are they are a water resistant chemical that some companies use to put on, say, like pans, like to keep them slippery, like Teflon. And the manufacturers of these PFAS, like DuPont, have not been very responsible in the way that they've handled these PFAS. And what they're finding is that these PFAS are getting into our tap water. Now, the problem with these PFAS is I just read an article that came out a month ago and wrote a blog post, which you can read under our blog at waterforlifeusa.com. But PFAS have been directly linked to health problems in women. Specifically, they are causing damages to unborn babies and even cancer in women. And for men, it's also carcinogenic, meaning it causes cancer. So these PFAS are very dangerous, and our EPA that regulates or and monitors the safety of our water, they are not getting out these PFAS. There isn't an effective treatment, and they haven't invested in the treatment, the more expensive treatments that are needed to remove them from our tap water. So high concentrations of PFAS are getting into our tap water, and this can be very detrimental to the health of women especially. Another problem with tap water has to do with deteriorating infrastructure, and this has to do with the pipes that deliver the water to our homes. They are getting old, they are getting rusty, there are holes in these pipes that are letting bacteria and viruses and things in it. And instead of replacing the pipes, our municipal water treatment companies and our cities are simply adding chemicals to these pipes. Chemicals like chromium 6 and chloramine. And these are heavy detergents. And the problem is they have also been linked to cancer. If you've ever seen the movie Erin Brockovich, it's about her fight against the local town's water company who was putting chromium 6 into the water and causing cancer in people in the town. So it's really dangerous what they're doing. The pipes need to be replaced, and these chemicals they're using is flat out dangerous to human health. And on top of all of that, our tap water is already full of chlorine, fluoride, leftover pharmaceutical drugs from people who are flushing their pills down the toilet, and from animal processing facilities that are using fertilizers that is getting into our water supply. So there's all kinds of antibiotics and drugs and things that are in our water that are just not getting filtered out by the time it gets to our homes, and it's making our tap water more and more dangerous to drink. Now, a solution that many Americans and people from all around the world have turned to is bottled water. Unfortunately, this has not been a very good solution. The problems with bottled water is that the bottles themselves are made from soft plastic. The soft plastic can leach BPA and BPB into our water, which are carcinogens, meaning they are cancer-causing. Specifically, a lot of bottled water is made by reverse osmosis or distillation, which we're going to cover here in just a second. But the bottom line is that the water is acidic, and this acidic water breaks down the soft plastic and allows these chemicals to get into our drinking water. Another problem is that 1.5 billion plastic bottles are made each day, and many of these bottles are ending up in our oceans and landfills, which is just creating a huge mess that, you know, if we don't deal with it, then our children are going to have to deal with it, and it's just not fair to them or to the fish in the oceans, or all the landfills that are getting filled up with this chemical-rich plastic. You know, it's just not healthy for us. Another problem has to do with the water bottling plants. They're not well regulated, so there have been many, many documented cases of people drinking bottled water and getting sick from high levels of bacteria and other contaminants that are getting into the water. And there's a lot of lying, I mean, for lack of a better word, just misleading advertising that has to do with this bottled water. You know, they show you beautiful springs and waterfalls, but the truth is, it's just, most of it is just filtered tap water. They're using reverse osmosis and distillations to filter city tap water and putting it in a bottle. So you're not getting what you pay for, and you might be getting some chemicals and things that you didn't bargain for at all that could be very unhealthy for you. So many Americans have turned to treating their water at home, and the most common way to treat water at home is through the use of a carbon water filter. Activated carbon is effective in removing chlorine, sediment, and basic contaminants from our tap water. However, it's not effective in removing fluoride, heavy metals, leftover pharmaceutical drugs, chloramine, chromium-6, and smaller contaminants. So it's basic filtration, but it's not removing the things that are most dangerous from our tap water. Instead of a carbon filter, many people are using reverse osmosis systems. These work by using a high amount of pressure to force your tap water through a very, very small membrane. And what happens is the water that's forced through this membrane ends up being pure water, and all the contaminants get left behind. So the result is everything is removed from your tap water, including the minerals, and the water that you end up drinking is in a empty acidic state. So believe it or not, reverse osmosis was never intended to create drinking water. It was created for labs, because when you're cleaning lab equipment, you need a pure water that's not going to leave behind anything on your lab equipment. And so reverse osmosis water is great for labs, but it's not great for people, because people need things from their water. They need minerals, trace minerals. They need oxygen. They need antioxidants. They need alkalinity. And when you use a reverse osmosis, you're just stripping everything out of the water and leaving it in an empty state that eventually can steal things from your own body, including minerals from your bones and nutrients, and make you unhealthy. It's the same problem with water distillers. Now, a water distiller creates a very similar water to reverse osmosis. A water distiller works by evaporating the water and then recondensing it. And everything that has been that was in the water gets left behind from when it was recondensed. So you end up with a pure water that's acidic and dead and stagnant, just like the reverse osmosis water. Perfect for labs, but not good for you. A better solution for in-home water filtration is a multi-stage water filter. This is a filtration system that's going to combine your activated carbon filter with other stages of filtration that target different contaminants in the water. So you'll have stages that can target the fluoride, the chloramine, the leftover pharmaceutical drugs. And through creating this multi-stage water filtration system, you end up removing all of the dangerous contaminants from your tap water. So this is a good idea, except it doesn't impact the pH of the water or the ORP of the water, which we'll go over right now. So what is pH? pH stands for potential of hydrogen. A pH scale ranges from 1 to 14. 1 is the strongest acid, 14 is the strongest alkaline or base, and 7 is neutral. Water that is acidic takes on properties of what it comes in contact with, so it rusts it. If you put metal in a strong acidic water, it's going to oxidize and rust it. It can also kill bacteria and viruses and sterilize things. So you don't want to be drinking an acidic water because of these reasons. You don't want water that's going to oxidize your body. You don't want water that can sterilize things. You want water that can help you. So anything that's above a 7 on a pH scale is considered alkaline. Alkaline water can be made alkaline by alkaline minerals or by an alkaline chemical structure or by both. And the benefit of this water is that it can give your body minerals. It can also give your body negative hydrogen ions, which is the antioxidant in water. And it also tends to be full of oxygen. So instead of being antioxidizing, this alkaline water has the potential to be antioxidizing. So acidic is oxidizing, alkaline, antioxidizing. Now the ORP is what they call the oxygen reduction potential of water. It measures the water's ability to either oxidize or reduce oxygen. So water that has a positive ORP is oxidizing. And this is where it gets a little bit complicated, because even if water is alkaline, it can have a positive ORP if it is stagnant and doesn't have negative ions in it. So if you drink water with a positive ORP, even if it is alkaline, it can still oxidize and damage your body. So simply drinking a bottled water that is full of minerals to make it alkaline does not mean that it is a healthy water to drink. The most important thing to look for is that you have to drink water that has a negative ORP. A negative ORP is considered reducing water, and what it's reducing is active oxygen in your cells. Another name for active oxygen is free radicals. Now, I know most of you are familiar with free radicals. They have been talked about for many, many years by doctors that free radicals damage our bodies. A certain amount is normal and healthy, but the pollution and emotional stress and poor diets that we've been exposed to have been increasing the amount of free radicals in our cells to extremely high levels. And this increases what they call oxidative stress levels in our cells. The way that you reduce oxidative stress and reduce the amount of free radicals is to eat and consume antioxidants. Now, you can get antioxidants from the food that you eat, like cantaloupe and blueberries and other types of berries, or you can get antioxidants from the water you drink if it is energized with ions. Now, nature makes the best water for us to drink. This natural water is full of natural minerals that the water is picking up from moving over rocks, and it is also energized by the sun and or kinetic movement from moving along its little stream bed. It creates energy in the water that makes it alkaline and gives it its antioxidants. This natural process of creating alkaline antioxidant water is called water electrolysis. And what it's doing is it's filling the drinking water, the water that we want to drink, with negatively charged dissolved hydrogen. Dissolved hydrogen is water's natural antioxidant to our body. Natural water is both alkaline and has this negative ORP caused by this dissolved hydrogen. Once water is removed from its energy source and put into a bottle or a municipal water treatment tank, this dissolved hydrogen fizzles away and the water becomes stagnant and dead and has a positive ORP. So even if your municipal water treatment facility is getting this water from a really good source that's full of alkalinity and natural antioxidants, just by storing that water in those tanks, all that antioxidant effect is fizzling away. It takes about 2 to 3 days. So that by the time it comes through your tap, all those benefits are gone. This is where a water ionizer comes in. A water ionizer creates natural water. It replicates the sun's natural water electrolysis through the use of platinum titanium plates. These positively and negatively charged plates create both alkaline and acidic water. It splits the water, and you can control the alkalinity and acidity of the water just by pushing a button. A water ionizer is the only way to create dissolved hydrogen and a natural alkaline chemical structure. Because if you try to bottle it, it will eventually become stagnant and dead by the time that you drink it. A water ionizer creates the perfect 9.5 pH water with 1,500 parts per billion of dissolved hydrogen in it. So that's more antioxidants than a glass of freshly squeezed orange juice for reference. So it is full of antioxidants that your body absolutely loves. Plus, a water ionizer filters the water with as many as 16 stages of filtration. So you're getting pure water that's energized and that is alkaline and full of minerals that your body loves. So the definition of ionized water is that it is tap water that has been purified using a multi-stage filtration system, and the antioxidants and alkalinity have been restored using water electrolysis. The result is antioxidant-rich and alkaline natural water. Briefly, I want to go over the history of ionized water. It was first invented in the 1900s in Japan. They created water ionizers back then for the purpose of creating acidic ionized water. They learned that when you spray this acidic ionized water on leaves, the insects don't like it and will keep away. So it works as a natural pesticide without having to use chemicals, which is cheaper and also better for the environment. It wasn't until the 1950s that these water ionizers gained popularity in Japan for the average person. That's when they discovered that the alkaline ionized water was found to have similar properties to the water from their longevity springs. So this natural water that people were drinking and living a really long time and living super healthy lives, they found that the alkaline ionized water from the water ionizers had the same properties. So they began to sell it as a wonder water and telling people that it had healing effects. Well, soon other countries like Korea, China, and Taiwan followed suit and began making their own water ionizers. And as of today, about a third of all Korean, Japanese, and other countries' people, about a third of them have water ionizers. So what do the experts say about ionized water? Well, there has been over 40 years of research done on ionized water, more than virtually any pharmaceutical drug. I say white papers on these notes because a lot of the drugs that we take that are in our pharmacies have been approved for us to take by what they call white papers. White papers are research done by the companies that make the drugs. So they're not peer reviewed, and that's why you find a lot of recalls and things going on with pharmaceutical drugs that are making people sick because they didn't go through the proper channels and have it peer reviewed, where other third party researchers will come in and test the validity of the conclusions that you reached about your own product. So what makes ionized water better is that over these 40 years, there have been hundreds and hundreds of peer-reviewed research papers done on ionized water. So it is the conclusions reached by these researchers are solid. And this has been around for a long time. It has been researched by the U.S. military. It has been researched by prestigious universities in the U.S. and Japan and Korea and China. And the results that they have found have been absolutely amazing because ionized water is so valid. It is approved by the Japanese Ministry of Health and the Korean Food and Drug Administration. Water ionizers are approved as medical devices. Water ionizers are used in hospitals and health clinics all around the world to treat people. They're even used in multiple professional sports teams, including the Baltimore Ravens and several minor league baseball teams. If you want to do your own research on ionized water, you need to look up electrolyzed reduced water, or ERW, and you can go to websites like PubMed.gov and search for ERW, or electrolyzed reduced water, and you'll see all the latest research. And here's what that research has discovered. Ionized water has been medically approved to treat diarrhea, indigestion, abnormal stomach or intestine fermentation. It controls acid in our body and treats acid indigestion. Antioxidants are effective in treating diabetes, which is rooted in high levels of oxidative stress in our cells. And reducing oxidative stress also improves our sleep patterns, our energy levels, our blood pressure, and even helps to prevent future adult onset diseases like even cancer. Because ionized water is reduced, it also hydrates our bodies three times more effectively. So water electrolysis reduces the size of the water molecule cluster, which makes it even more hydrating, up to three times more hydrating than any other type of water that we can drink unless it's coming straight from a pristine spring or glacial stream or some other natural source. So now I want to talk about the different types of water ionizers. The first type is a countertop water ionizer. A countertop water ionizer sits on your countertop and it has all the controls built into the front panel. You have your alkaline button, your acid button, your pure water button, and your volume. There are four alkaline levels, four acid levels, and you can choose each level just by pressing those buttons. So if I wanted to drink the best drinking water, I set the machine to alkaline level number 3, and then I press that on button right at the bottom there. And then it's going to create a perfect 9.5 pH water with about a minus 300 ORP, which is the same properties that you're going to find in the best waters all around the world. This particular countertop water ionizer is the Genesis Steel, and it features a stainless steel faceplate. It also has a stainless steel hose for dispensing the water. And the screen in the middle there displays everything you need to know about your water. It displays the pH, the ORP, the water flow, and the filter life. Now, an undersink water ionizer does everything that a countertop water ionizer can do, except the main difference is that all the plates and filters are in that base, which you see in the back of the picture there, and that base goes underneath your sink instead of sitting on the counter. The only thing that goes above your counter is that faucet there in the front, and that faucet has all the buttons built right into the top. That faucet is fully stainless steel except for the top portion there where the buttons are, and both the countertop and undersink water ionizers, they feature dual filtration with 16 stages of filters. So you're going to get all those stages that target each of the difficult contaminants in your water so that you are drinking the healthiest water that is also alkaline and full of antioxidants. Why should you choose Water for Life USA? Well, as I said at the very beginning, we have been doing this since December of 2006. That's almost 16 years in the business, which is much longer than almost all of our competitors. We are the exclusive distributors for our products, not dealers. So we are responsible for shipping them directly to you. And we handle all the warranty repairs in-house. We do not have any third party that repairs our water ionizers. Over the course of 16 years, we have earned an A+ rating with the Better Business Bureau. And we back our products with a 5 years parts, labor, and shipping warranty. So anything that goes wrong with your water ionizer in 5 years, we will fix for free. We also back our water ionizers with a 60-day money-back guarantee. And over these 16 years, we have accumulated thousands upon thousands of satisfied customers. So we are very proud of our reputation for selling high quality products and backing them up with excellent customer support. If you'd like to learn more about anything in this presentation, please, or about our products, please visit waterforlifeusa.com or give us a call at 877-255-3713 or email us info@waterforlifeusa.com. Thank you so much for your time. I know it's very valuable, and I hope that this presentation answered some of the questions you have about ionized water. And of course, we are here to answer your questions should you have any. Have a wonderful day.